Hey guys, Mark here. Many people love blurry background on picture. Of course, the best way to get it is to use low aperture lens and focus exactly on the subject. But if because of any reasons this is not possible, for example, you don't have such lens or pictures has been already taken, but you would like to get such effect in Lightroom, then in this video, I will show you some tricks you can use to get exactly that effect. We can start right now. Let's take that picture as very simple first example. What we have here? We have two subjects in the same distance from us, and the background is after them also in the same distance. I mean, there is no subjects which are closer and farther. So this is really, really simple example. What we are doing, we are clicking on mask and we are trying to find the subject. Clicking here and Lightroom is doing it for us. Waiting a moment. Okay, subject has been found. So right now what I need to do is to invert, because I would like to impact on background, not on the subjects. So I'm clicking and I'm choosing invert. Okay, it's done. But to be honest, also this should be in focus. So I'm choosing minus here because and brush, because I would like subtract something. Okay, I'm doing it very, very quickly. So definitely you can do that better than I'm doing right now, but I hope it will be good enough for that example. Okay, so what we have done, we selected background, and right now I'm going to clarity first and I'm going down. You can see the difference. Okay, apart of that, I'm changing textures, also putting it down. Also, you could see the difference. Yeah, it is. And sharpness, but for this example, it has no special benefits. I will put it low. Okay, let's see what is the effect. On the left side, you can see our picture without blurry background and on the right with. So, of course, subject is not changed, as you can see, but everything what is behind, it is. You can see the text here is sharp and this is definitely not. And this is everywhere. Okay, so it was quite quick and easy, but it was the easiest example what I have. Okay, second example. Let's firstly try to do exactly that what we have done previously. I mean, I'm trying to select subject and invert it. Let's give a few seconds to Lightroom. Okay, as expected, really nice work. So I'm going to invert it. Okay, cool. So we have marked everything apart of our subject, because subject we want to have still sharp, of course. And I'm going to clarity, maybe not so much as previously. I'm going to put textures down and sharpness also. Okay, cool. But you can see the difference. Previously, it was looking natural. Right now, it is not. Why? Because here, grass should be sharp also. So how we can do that? Quite easily. I can click. Okay, maybe let's keep it marked. I'm clicking minus and I will subtract linear gradient. So you will see. I'm creating new gradient here. Okay. Clicking shift to make it very straight. And let's put it here. Okay, so you can see everything what is marked on red will be impacted with our blur effect. What is not marked, it will be not. But here we have also gradient. So this is not like jump from 0 to 1. This will be quite a slight change. Okay, let's see how it looks like. Okay, you can see here the grass is still sharp and getting less and less sharp. Let's compare it with our previous picture. So you can see there is difference. Okay, cool, done. Okay guys, let's take a look a bit on theory. We have something what is called aperture, and very relevant to that, f-stop. It is generally saying how much light can come through your lens into your camera. If lot of light is coming, then we have low aperture and very narrow depth of field. Depth of field is saying how many items will be in focus. Exactly on which distance from the point you are focusing, items will be in focus. So let's take a look on that picture. We have guy with camera here. He set f-stop something like 2.8, let's say, and he focused on that guy. So that guy will be in focus because he focused on him, but as well, other two guys will be in focus because they are in the same distance. But guys in the front and behind will be blurry. And if he will move the focus, it will impact, of course. But if he will go farther with f-stop and put some bigger values, that it will impact on depth of field as well. So it will be bigger. So you can see for the same example, he's focusing on the guy in the center, but more guys in the focus. Guys which are in the same distance will be very sharp. Guys which will be on the very border of the depth of field will be less focus. I mean less sharp. Okay, but if we will go farther and we will put higher f-stops, we will have higher aperture and very large depth of field. If we will set our focus rightly, we will have a lot of items in focus. And this is very, very welcome for landscape photography. But let's get back to our examples. We would like to simulate the depth of field, rather smaller than bigger. So we will need to put our subject in sharp, and we would like to go with some kind of transition into the blurry. Let's go further. Next example, and let's try to do that what we have done for the previous one. I mean, I'm selecting subject, and after that I will invert it. Okay, and right now we will be working on the gradient to have transition from sharp to blurry in front and in the back. Okay, but let's firstly try to work on that blurry background. So I'm going down with sharpness. Okay, and I think effect is quite good. To be honest, I even don't think I need anything more. Yes, I think the texture is impacting too much. So yes, for this example, only sharpness per my view. But let's go further and let's work. So I will trying to subtract, taking linear gradient. Okay. And what I'm doing, I'm trying to have the transition after her. So I'm putting it not very straight intentionally, because here is distance is a bit further. And okay, cool. A part of that, I would like to have some blurry in front, so I'm adding this time also radial gradient. Okay, right now I would like to be straight. Cool. And let's see. So I think transition after her is not bad. Here maybe this is too strong, maybe. So let's work on it. Okay, front. Okay, and behind her, maybe a bit longer. Okay, so you can see what we got. We have in focus her and everything what is around on the left and right, but in front and in the back, everything is blurry. Okay, and let's quickly compare what we have. So on the left, we can see before, and on the right is after. So you can see everything is blurry, and it was not before. And also in the front, we had sharpness only. Right now we have a bit of blurry. If we'd like, we can make that transition a bit longer, of course. Okay, cool. Okay guys, here intentionally I prepared that mask in advance, but exactly in the same way how we did it earlier. And what is issue here? As you know, the field of depth is saying what is sharp and what is not sharp. And it depends on the distance between the point which we are focusing and the item we are determining if this is sharp or not sharp. So issue here is that palm, because as well as the bottom of her and the top is in the same distance, but Lightroom is 2D tool only, so for him everything is in the same, I mean it's even not distance, this is the trick what we are using. So what we can do with that, we can do some manual correction. So I'm clicking subtract and we'll subtract brush, but not full. I would like to have something like 80%, because it should be slightly blurry because it is outside of her. I'm doing it quite quickly, but you can do that more accurate. But anyway, let's say this is, this is good enough. Okay, so right now you can see this is less blurry, but this is still sharp. And if you have more such elements in your picture, that this trick can become more and more harder. Okay guys, here also I create that mask in advance, but I'm presenting you that example to show that it's not always worth to try to use that trick. So here we have situation where maybe behind of her there is no problems, but in front of her we have such complicated thing. So we will need spend manual efforts to remove it from mask. And if you would like to have some blurry also in front of her, it will be even more difficult and the effect can be not fine. A part of that, you can imagine here we would have more such items or people walking around. So it will be really big portion of efforts and per my view, not worth. So what I'm kindly recommending you is to not try with too complicated pictures, because final effect may looks not natural. Quick summary. You could see that getting blurry effects in Lightroom can be very easy or even trivial. But depends on situation, it can be difficult or maybe even too much time consuming. But the most important is that you know how those rules works, how it's being created in the reality. If you know that, you can use Lightroom rightly to get the best possible effects and still let your picture looks natural, what is per my view super important. I hope guys you enjoyed that video. I really appreciate if you click like button and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like that in the future. Thank you very much.